世界第二的蔡振华。
Talk about 1983, the World Championship. It was the first time that you challenged the number two player at that time, Cai Renhua, and you were only 18. Were you intimidated in any way?
Yeah, of course. It was my first big final and my first big tournament against him and against the whole team from China. It was a big thing for me to do.
What went through your mind when you looked that guy into his eyes?
Yeah, he looked very strong. Yeah,
he
had a lot of power, and he was not so small. He was quite big
quite
and
big,、yeah.
strong.
瓦尔德内尔这员小将确实打得很果断，在这个关键的时候他不手软。22平、23平，球没有过。24平，球打中了。25平、27平，球没有过。28平。
这场比赛最终蔡振华靠经验以30-28险胜。然而中国队教练和队员都产生了同一个感觉，这位瑞典少年绝对不可小视。
But that was a great game. You had eight ties after you reached 20.
A long second set and of course I had my chances and he had his chances and he took it in the end, yeah. But he had also a different style to play against. He played a very difficult game.
When you were having the eight ties with Cai Zhenhua for your first match, what did you say to yourself? Like, you know, I have to hand on to this.
Because you only want to win the set, yeah, and you think maybe about set balls or something, but I was quite young this time. Also, I was only, I think, 17 years old, so I didn't think too much, I think, and it was also not like...my biggest loss or something. I know I got more chances later. Mm.
But you had nothing to lose as a young player,
of course,
right?
Of course we have nothing to lose in this match. I think it's always like in sport. You have to lose in the beginning to learn how to win also. I think so. Mm. It's important to know how to lose because then you have more experience for the next time. It was the same when I lost. I say maybe my best year is coming and it was right.
此后蔡振华退役，老瓦开始面对他的第二代中国对手，这时的老瓦依然屡屡碰壁。这是1985年第38届世乒赛，老瓦对战中国二号快攻手陈龙灿。赛后老瓦称，这是我最糟糕的一场球，而瑞典队更是在这次男团决赛中被中国队剃了个光头，0-5。但是老瓦并没有甘心失败，而是默默研究中国队的打法，希望能够找到破解之术，夺得胜利。
But in 1989, you had your revenge against China, 5-0 this time. How did you find way to counter react to the Chinese techniques?
Yeah, I think we played many times against the same players.
I heard that you studied different players' techniques so much that you actually can play in their style once their names were mentioned. Was that
true? No, but I like always to study much from table tennis and also Chinese styles, how they play, because they was the best in the world, so of course you have to study how they play.
1989年第40届世乒赛，人们惊奇地发现一个崭新的老瓦出现了，不管哪个中国选手上场，他都能灵活应对，出奇制胜。这一次瑞典队还给了中国一个5-0，成为世界男子乒坛新霸主，而老瓦摘得了单打冠军，成为无可争议的世界乒坛之王。中国媒体感叹于他这样神奇又多变的打法，送给他一个中国特色的外号，游击队长。
And we know probably who gonna play, and we have a good practice to play against this style. And we know that they have played with some penholder style, and this was very important for us.
此后几年，中国第二代选手也陆续退役，第三代选手马文革、王涛相继加入。而老瓦始终雄居世界男乒之巅，先后夺得1990年世界杯和1992年巴塞罗那奥运会单打冠军。那段时期的瓦尔德内尔成了第三代中国选手一座难以跨越的高峰。 1995年第43届世乒赛上，年轻的第四代中国选手登场，刚满20岁的孔令辉和刘国梁以初生牛犊不怕虎的劲头，向瑞典队发起了近6年来最强有力的冲击。中国乒乓球队终于打了个翻身仗，重新夺回冠军。虽然瑞典队是这次比赛的输家，但老瓦仍以13胜1负的总成绩雄居世界排名首位。所以有人说，中国男乒重新夺回了世界乒坛制高点，但他们上面却站着一个瑞典人，瓦尔德内尔。而这时的老瓦已经年满30。
Now I'm more used to play against younger players all the time. And okay, when I play in the league, it's not the same because there are more older players. Because you have many Chinese young players, many from Asia who's young. Then, but always it doesn't matter. You don't think how old they are. You only think about your game to play your best. I think this is the most important when you go into the matches.
Yeah. 中瑞之间依然此消彼长，竞争激烈。中国第五代选手王励勤、马林和第六代王浩也相继登场，而老瓦却似乎毫不在意自己的年纪，依然和那些比自己年轻10几20岁的对手拼杀在球场上。而这时，他的第一代对手蔡振华和第四代对手刘国梁已经分别成为中国体育界的官员和教练。人们被老瓦执着的体育精神所感动，送给他又一个称号，常青树。
First and foremost, you are known as the player, the rival for 6 generations of Chinese table tennis players. How do you, what do you make out of this? How do you look at this?
Yeah.